Midjourney version 6 is here and it's absolutely amazing. I had no doubt that Midjourney would eventually come out on top again and add some of the much needed features to compete with the likes of DALL-E 3. Feels weird even saying that, because DALL-E has always been inferior to Midjourney until DALL-E 3 was released, at least in my opinion. You can argue that DALL-E had a good run when Midjourney first came out, but let's be honest, it was like comparing an image that had 12 fingers and a melting face to an image that had 15 fingers and a melting face. Let's just say, AI art has come a long way in a year. Alrighty, so I'm a little bit late to the Midjourney version 6 release party. So this might not be the first Midjourney version 6 video that you've watched. So I'm going to focus specifically on some of the new details such as how to prompt text and the tweaks that you can make to get better results. Also, it's important to note in the V6 announcement, it states it is significantly different when compared to version 5, and you will literally have to relearn how to prompt. They actually put that in bold, so it doesn't seem like a minor change. The new version also boasts improved coherency along with model knowledge, along with improvements to prompting and remixing. No longer are the days that you have to put in the words award-winning 8K render or super duper beautiful to enhance your image. They actually called that junk in the announcement. Can you believe that? Junk? That's crazy to me because those were like my go-to words to enhance the beauty of my image or to make it photorealistic, award-winning masterpiece, aka Octane render-ish. Oh well, so much for my older advanced tutorial, which I'll still put in my video description. Now version 6 is still an alpha, so it won't be in the default option. So you have to go into settings and change it to version 6 or add --V6 at the end of your prompt. You might also notice that some of the features won't be available, features such as pan, zoom, vary region, upscale, tune, and --describe will not work at the moment for version 6. Okay, so let's take a look at version 6 alpha. Type in --settings in your Discord prompt and press enter twice and use the drop-down box to choose the model version 6 alpha. Yes, Midjourney is still exclusively on Discord, but will be coming soon to a browser near you. I'd also like to take this time to mention that relax mode works with V6, but if you're on the $10 plan like I am right now, version 6 is slower and costs more in fast hours. So keep that in mind before you prompt away because you might hit the wall real quick. Okay, so while we're in settings, I want to draw your attention to some of the settings that you might want to get familiar with if you're trying to get better text within your images. As per version 6 release notes, choosing a style raw or lowering the stylized value will help force Midjourney to adhere to your prompt, which can help you with text generation if that is your main focus. By default, Midjourney selects stylized medium, which is stylized with the value 100. However, you might want to set this to a lower value if you're not getting the results you want. Alternatively, you can type --stylize or --s and then set it to a value under 100. You can also do multiple tests at once by using permutations and try using multiple different values by putting --open curly bracket s 50, s then 100 here, 200 and closed at squiggly bracket. And this will give you three different images from those styles, one for 50, one for stylized 100, and then another one for 200. And then you can compare which one is better. By the way, you can also type --style raw if you wanted to enable the raw style. Then you're telling Midjourney, I don't care about your opinion and I want to stylize it, not you. The last tip I want to give you for text, and certainly not the least, I don't even know if this is a tip, this is mandatory, but you will have to put your text or phrase in quotations. This will tell Midjourney, I want anything in these quotes to be text, and don't confuse anything in this quote as the prompt either. Also consider using multiple strings or multiple phrases in quotations to help divide up longer phrases that Midjourney can't do by default. Or combine different formats of text such as text made out of metal next to text made out of neon lights. And you can even put multiple words in different locations such as text on the right side of the screen and text on the left side of the screen. Just to manage expectations, you're going to mess up a lot and it's going to be like 1 out of 4. Maybe some people get it 50%, but normally you're going to have to keep doing variations. Like here I have mild journey instead of mid journey, but that one's close enough for you. If you just did a variation, it would correct it. Here you can see the text was corrected and I just used a subtle variation after upscaling it to make that slight correction, and it was able to do it first try, and that's not always the case, but for me this time first try, and it spelt it Midjourney instead of mild journey with two E's. Before we go any further, I think I have to address this image right here. So this image was actually made with the style raw version and no prompts. So I guess this is like the sick mind of Midjourney. This has to be one of the sickest things I've ever seen. All right, let's continue. So let me show you a quick trick to kind of clean up the image a little bit. using Photopia or Photopea or Photopea. So just head over to photopia.com and I'll leave this link in my description, and then just go ahead and upload any picture that you have from Midjourney. That's almost good. You can see here, this one has an additional U here, which we don't want. So let's fix that. And you know what? We could fix the top of the U as well. And then we're going to fix the shall, and it's going to be really quick. So first let's get rid of that extra U because it says you shall you not pass. That's not what we want. We want you shall not pass. So you can click on the stamper tool right here, and that's the clone tool. And then up here, you can change the size. I'm going to make it a lot bigger, big. And then I'm going to hold Alt and then left click right on the O. Now that's our center point. So I want the O to be right here and just rub it in until we get what we want. Now I'm going to hold Alt and click on a blank space here and start getting rid of the other stuff. You can also just click around instead of holding left click. All right, so that blended pretty good. But if it didn't blend as well as you wanted, you can click on this little Band-Aid looking icon here, which is the heal tool. Go up here, increase the size and lower the hardness. Then for anything that doesn't mesh, you can hold Alt, then click somewhere and then just kind of mesh it in. We don't really need that. Now we want to fix the top of the U here because it's a little sharp. So let's go back to the clone tool and make it a lot smaller. And then I'm going to hold Alt and left click in the black portion here. And I'm going to use this as like a painting tool right now. So just go ahead and do some kind of small strokes upward. You don't want to go too far because it's going to actually start recreating other parts of the image. There we go. I think the U looks a lot better now. Now let's fix the alignment of the shall here. So you make this a little bit bigger. And then I'm going to go right over the S and hold Alt and left click. I'm going to just move down a little bit and then just rub it in. When I say rub it in, I'm holding the left click. And then the all is a little bit off, so grab that. There you go. It's better aligned and we got rid of the U and it looks better. Cool thing about Photopea is like you don't owe it anything. You don't have to sign in. You just got some ads here on the side and that's like basically it. It's free. I'll leave some advanced Photopea tutorials in the description if you're at all interested. It's a pretty powerful and free tool and alternative to Adobe Photoshop. Okay, so I think I went over most of version 6 and it's still in alpha and they're going to add more features. And when they start adding the inpainting and being able to kind of focus in where the text should be, it's going to help a lot, but that feature is not there yet. So while looking through Midjourney community feed, I saw a lot of cool pictures and I also created a lot of pictures. So I'm actually going to show that here at the end of the video so you can kind of get a feel for what version 6 can produce. I'll have some images that are my own, some with text, but most of these are going to be community images and they look pretty good. So I'm going to show you these pictures now, but before I go, if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. I really appreciate it if you do. It helps me out big time. And we're coming into the new year, so happy new year and do great things this year.